walked into a board meeting, prepared to give her pitch to a mostly male crowd. Before she could introduce herself, one man turned to her and said, "I'd like a latte, please." Belittled, undermined, and stereotyped, with only 5 words. It is situations like these that lead to so many women believing that they are outsiders in their own workplace, believing that they are not good enough to do a job that they are more than qualified to do, and believing that a career in the technology industry is not worth the constant uphill battle against stereotypes. No wonder there is such a limited number of women in technology. And why is this still the case? Simply because contemporary society continues to enforce these stereotypical expectations of women, making it impossible to close the gender gap in this field. Of course, it's not only women who are stereotyped against. Both men and women are heavily influenced in their career choices by society's expectations. The statistics prove this. When thinking of their future, it's clear which jobs a young boy or girl will feel compelled to aspire towards. But for me, as a female looking at a career in the technology industry, the gender gap in this field is a massive issue. Knowing that this career choice will lead to continual discrimination and the fight against stereotypes is enough to change the minds of many young girls seeking technology as a career path. Furthermore, those few women who are able to push past society's stereotypes and seek a career in technology are often faced with discrimination due to their gender. In fact, women make up just 27% of the tech workforce, and of that 27%, half leave the industry before the age of 35. The discrimination faced by these women must be horrific for half to leave the industry so soon after starting their career. At a recent Girls in ICT event, guest speaker Brooke Fossey told the crowd that she sat in university lectures as the only woman in the room, and this continued into her workplace. She said that encountering another woman in a meeting was rare, whereas feeling outcast or looked down upon was common. This is a harsh reality for many women in this field, and a 2022 study found that 72% of women report being outnumbered by men in business meetings by a ratio of at least 2 to 1, while 26% report being outnumbered by 5 to 1 or more. Let me give you an example. Do you know the story of Ada Lovelace? Do you know what she accomplished? Have you even heard her name? This incredible woman wrote the first ever computer program in the 1840s. That's right, you can thank Ada Lovelace for your smartphones. What is ludicrous is that male mathematician and inventor Charles Babbage was credited with her work as he created the engine that Lovelace created her program for. This absolute disregard for women's intelligence has not stopped. Over a century later, Jocelyn Bell Burnell discovered neutron stars while working as a research assistant at Cambridge. Despite her revolutionary discovery, Burnell received 0 credit for her work, while in 1974, her male advisors received the Nobel Prize for Physics. History's repeated inattention to the inventions and discoveries of women has led to limited female role models to look up to in the technology industry. With so few stories of successful women in technology, how can we expect more young girls to seek a career in this field and close the gender gap in this industry? People in technology are responsible for creating many things that we use daily. But without the input of women, the needs of this gender are often overlooked. This leads to inventions and products that suit only half of the population. This then begs the question of how can all people have their needs and voices heard in the development of our world through technology, when half of the population has so little representation? Both men and women have valuable qualities to bring to this industry. Everyone has their own unique management and leadership style, and with a more even balance of males and females, the quality of outputs in this industry can only expand. However, while the gender gap in technology is still substantial, there are more and more educational opportunities for young people, and in encouraging more young girls to seek a career in this industry. Events such as the Girls in ICT Day inspire more young girls to seek a career in this field, where women in technology are finally receiving more recognition than ever before. Because of this, many more inspirational women in this field are visibly making a difference in technology, paving the way for more young girls to seek a career in tech. Elizabeth Churchill has held positions at various tech companies, such as Yahoo, eBay, and Google, where she is currently Director of User Experience. She is also Vice President of the Association of Computing Machinery and has over 50 patents granted or pending and more than 100 published articles in multiple fields of psychology and computing. Amy Hood, another trailblazing woman in technology, is the first female Chief Financial Officer in Microsoft history. She works to increase the big tech company's long growth while promoting a culture of equality for women in large leadership roles. She also speaks regularly at events such as Fortune's Most Powerful Women Summit. Melanie Perkins, the CEO and co-founder of Canva, is another example of an inspirational woman in technology. She is one of the youngest female CEOs and one of Australia's richest women, with her startup valued at over $1 billion. With role models such as these incredible women to look up to and the support of many behind them, more girls can break the age-old stereotypes and succeed in the technology industry. Everyone has their part to play in closing the gender gap in this field, starting with an acknowledgement that programming, electronics, and technology can be a universal interest. By providing the same opportunities to both boys and girls, we can put a stop to the pressure placed on all children by the accepted gender stereotypes regarding future careers. How can we stop this? More role models, more opportunities, and less stereotypes. Let's close the gender gap in technology before the world moves on without women.